and that is the Canadian and U.S. national anthems. Here's Rene Rancourt.
The singing of the Canadian and American national anthems, performed this evening by a Garden legend, accompanied by Bruins organist Ron Poster. Please welcome Rene Rancourt.
Starting goalies for this Game 7, and the two goaltenders that have been going at it since the start of this series, it'll be James Reimer. This was considered to be perhaps the weak link for Toronto in this series. He was pretty good in the first four games. He's been terrific in the last two, both 2-1 wins for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And on the other end, Tuukka Rask played in only one other Game 7. Not a great memory. It was a loss here against Philadelphia in 2010 on the Flyers' way to the Stanley Cup Finals, so Rask will try to erase that memory as the Leafs and the Bruins. 80-plus years of a rivalry in the National Hockey League, and this is only the third Game 7 that these two franchises have gone head-to-head. David Krejci with his familiar line mates of Nathan Horton and Milan Lucic. They have done the bulk of the scoring for the Bruins out against the line that Randy Carlyle never ran in the pregame warm-ups, but that's not unusual for him as McClement is out here with Fratton and Van Riemsdyk. As Lucic on the far side tips it ahead, could be a two-on-one here. Krejci with Horton. Gardner, the only man back, a shot, save, rebound, chance to stop by Reimer, and then off the side of the net. It is cleared aside by Gardner.
Shades of the way Krejci did it early in the series. He had three shots at that.
Cody Flamson now. Makes a bump along the boards as it's picked up now by the Bruins out to the high slot. Lucic to the front of the net. Redirected. Reimer juggles momentarily as Jágr got a stick on that. And then a little pushing and shoving after the whistle.
What a start for the Boston Bruins. You'd think Franzen would have learned from Dion Phaneuf in game four because he got caught up in the offensive zone and awaited the races early on here for the Boston Bruins. After that, there's the second chance there by Jágr. But there's Franzen stepping up on the plate. Very similar to the way Phaneuf did in game four in overtime, and it cost him the game. Really good saves there by Reimer. Three whacks at him. Not a terrifically great shot on the first one. You would think that Krejci could have gone a little bit higher. He shot it sort of right into the middle of him. Maybe he was playing a rebound, but it didn't go in.
And here is Jaromir Jágr taking Tyler Seguin's normal spot with Brad Marchand and Patrice Bergeron. This is something that Claude Julien hinted at in the pregame press conference, but wouldn't confirm. Pass to the front of the net in the crease area. Bergeron took a swipe at it and comes out to the line. Boychuk. Across for Matt Barkowski, number 43. Kind of surprising. He's in the lineup for Wade Redden. A chance in front. It's blocked by the Maple Leafs. And Clark MacArthur able to chip it ahead. And Kuhlman will send it into the Boston zone.
Well, the good thing for Toronto, obviously, is they've survived this. You try to put the other team under stress as quickly as you can in a Game 7. This Toronto team has a lot of young guys who have never been in this situation, and virtually the whole Boston Bruins team has many times over the last 2 or 3 years alone.
And, Brian, I don't imagine there's too many guys even that have Game 7 experience that played Game 6 the night before in a different city as this shot on Reimer misses the net.
That's a great point. You don't see that very often. This is like one giant game. This is period four.
On top of that, as many of the hockey world are aware of, the Boston Bruins found out during their game, we got a penalty coming here, a delayed call against Boston.
And Peverly and Kadri are going at it. They got in each other's face, and Kadri just take a swing there, too. Look like we're going to get both of them going.
Well, if that's the case, a great job there by Peverly, because clearly Boston was getting the only penalty. Toronto had the puck. And the officials are talking, Brian.
Well, Peverly is a very experienced guy. There's the initial hit there. Oh yeah, he slew-footed him. There is no doubt about that. And Kadri wasn't very happy about it afterwards. They started jawing at each other. Peverly did the smart thing, stayed right in his face, pressed the kid, and the kid blew up a little. He should have walked away. There's lots of time in this game for Nazem Kadri to have gotten back against him, and he ends up in the penalty box.
I could not hear the announcement of the penalties, Brian. There may have been an extra two, though, even though each team has a man in the box. Yes, the Bruins now are sending Sean Thornton over. So indeed an extra penalty called against Boston. And so Toronto has the first power play of this Game 7 presented by Kia Motors. And neither team has been particularly effective on the power play, although Toronto a little bit better at 4-for-18 compared to the Bruins, who have scored just three. Also on 18 opportunities is Van Riemsdyk. Trying to slide it to the Kessel. Big collision there with Tara. They both went down. As Phaneuf, who had a huge goal in Game 6 last night, but now it is Tara sending it all the way back into the Toronto zone.
Tara got close to Kessel, all right, right in the corner. He actually lost his balance as well. This is where you can find out how bad the nerves are or how good on a power play early in the game in Game 7 for Toronto.
Tara hammers the puck around. It'll be held in. Cody Franzen sends it across now for Dion Phaneuf. Bergeron trying to hang on to him. Back to the line, Van Riemsdyk rolls it across. Franzen straight away. Phaneuf, little touch pass for Kessel. Kessel at the dot. His shot was blocked by Boychuk. Backhanded to the side of the net. Van Riemsdyk is there. Poked away very calmly by Rath, but not out. Lupo! Oh, that hit a leg in front.
And also hit Chara's stick. That great long reach of Zdeno Chara made all the difference. And Boston is playing ugly. Look at Chara and Van Riemsdyk behind the play. Chara just threw him down to the ice, and there will be no penalty on the play. Wow.
Well, Brian, you know well that how a game is officiated can go a long ways to the outcome, especially if one team really wants to play more aggressive physically than the other.
No doubt. I watched Zdeno Chara in the warm-up. He skated, and he almost wore himself out. The concentration on his face was fantastic. Oh,
big collision there. Grabowski and Kelly, but the least controlling here is Jake Gardner. Sends it on the far side, a one-timer, and it trickled through Raskin just wide out the near side. Grabowski knocked away by McQuaid. MacArthur sends it around. John Michael Lyles with it now. Peverly's penalty is over. He's got to stay and serve the other two, but Sean Thornton is out. Teams at full strength. Kuhlman straight away for Lyles. Winds up, lets it go, and it's blocked up on the netting and out of play as McQuaid and Grabowski going at it.
John Michael Lyles had a fantastic shot from the point. He kept it low, and it was labeled for just inside the far goalpost. Look at the screen in front. Tuukka Rask never saw it. He was looking to his left, and the puck was going to his right. Look at Rask. That's just a reaction. He could feel it coming, and it just grazes by. Look at the Kelly hit on Grabowski. Grabowski was trying to go into the middle of the ice. Chara behind the play with Van Riemsdyk. Throws him down. Greco-Roman wrestling. Yeah, he's got a history, but his dad was one in the Olympics. There was a little bit of it right there. Van Riemsdyk is not a small guy, but Chara is gigantic.
Well, I mentioned at the top of the show, Brian, as a team, certainly Boston has more Game 7 experience, but there are some key performers for the Maple Leafs, including Van Riemsdyk and Lupo, that have played in Game 7 and played huge roles for their teams, as Quinnipiac able to reverse it back now for his partner Gunnarsson. Up the left side, Jay McClement hands it off now for Colton Orr across the line with a shot here that is steered up on the glass and out of play by Tuukka Rask.
Claude Julien just wanted his guys to play desperate. He didn't want to wait for them to get down on the scoreboard like they did the last couple of games before they started to get desperate. They've had a lot of adversity. After the game last night in Toronto, their plane malfunctioned. They had to stay in Toronto. Toronto flew here to Boston. So Boston was in Toronto. Toronto was in Boston. What's wrong with this picture? We're in Boston here for Game 7. And so you have to roll with the punches there. Nothing felt right coming home here, 10 o'clock, 10:30 this morning, landing for the Boston Bruins, knowing Toronto had been here last night.
Jagr chips it ahead, Marchand, so the second chip for this combination. Bergeron almost knocked it out of midair, as Reimer was just off the post of it, a giveaway by the Leafs, but a pass is intercepted in the high slot by Fratton. He'll send it back the other way. And Boychuk will pick it up now for the Bruins. Long diagonal stretch pass, and that's deflected by Phaneuf. Out of play as Phaneuf and Marchand come together in front of the Toronto bench.
Well, the Bergeron line has been shifted around. Sagan is off and Jagr is on because they only have 3 points in the series and one goal. They almost had their second goal. Bergeron bunts it out of the air. Reimer's been really good down low, boy. I mean, they've been jamming at him. It started off in that first two-on-one with Krejci taking second and third chances at it. Toronto a little bit slow to react here, but Reimer is ready again. It's fantastic. The last two games Reimer has been, he's had 2 games in this series already where he's had more than 40 saves, and you're looking at this game going in that direction the way Boston's playing at the moment.
Toronto for the second straight game without their top center Tyler Bozak. He took the warm-up last night, never touched a puck or handled it in the warm-up, so a lot of speculation before they announced it that he wasn't going to play. He did not even make the trip here for this Game 7. So Joe Colburn, number 32, a former Boston Bruins draft pick who was part of the Thomas Caberlet trade, is in his second ever Stanley Cup playoff game here in a Game 7 on the road. Bronson, giveaway. Barkowski walks in with a shot. Scores!
Pucks play along the wall. Boston Bruins have done it so far. They pull the puck off the wall and get it to Matt Barkowski. He's the one to kick the puck in his zone in the first place. Then Lucic is up against Franzen, but they control the puck. Barkowski in the middle, a little bit of a screen there, but Reimer looked like that one beat him low on the stick side. Barkowski gets a lot of penetration. There's a moving screen in front of him, and that is David Krejci positioning in front of the net. The Boston Bruins are taking it to Toronto at every level. They finally got one goal to show for it.
We don't know if there's something wrong with Wade Redden or whether it was just a hunch by Claude Julien, but Barkowski figures in the first goal of this Game 7. Crowd reacts as Bergeron knocked down Phaneuf. Another collision, and Phaneuf comes over, puts a big hit on Marchand. Here is Jagr. It is Barkowski, unassisted goal on the clean giveaway by the Maple Leafs. Marchand had it knocked off his stick, and it's cleared ahead to Van Riemsdyk, and he'll just flip it back into the Boston zone. Big hit by Chara, and Colton Orr steps into him. Colton Orr's going to go after Zdeno Chara here as much as he can to let him know that he's the not going to go unnoticed or unchallenged for the physical play he's putting on the other Maple Leaf players.
And Sadao Chara is not going to go there, but the ferocity with which Chara and the whole Bruin team is playing with right now is incredible.
Now McClement trying to clear. McQuaid blocked it. Rolls it to the front. It's picked off. And Ryan O'Byrne, a trade deadline acquisition from Colorado, sends it all the way back down behind Tuukka Rask. Angle off the boards and back the other way into the Maple Leaf zone. Barkowski's first career playoff goal in just his second game. He only played a little over 6.5 minutes in the one other game he played in this series, Brian. Up the far side now. Lead pass. Now it bounces off of Lupo. He's behind the defense. He's in! What a save! And a penalty coming against Chara.
Joffrey Lupo is a very opportunistic player. He's a very streaky scorer, and he's got great wheels. Got a couple of goals in this series already, and the Tuukka Rask just robbed him on this play as he came in all alone. Lupo's got great speed. He catches Zdeno Chara a little flat-footed. Gets Chara tried to poke the puck, and it went right off of Lupo and in front of him. Chara ends up reaching out, hits him with a high stick. Chara in the penalty box for high sticking. Power play Toronto.
Second power play for the Leafs, presented by Kia. As Peverly off his stick, and it's backhanded by Boychuk for the Bruins back into the Maple Leaf zone. Barkowski with the first goal of this game seven, unassisted at 5:39. Now Tuukka Rask leaves it there. Barkowski will wrap it around. Thompson able to hold it in. Sends it back in deep. Bruins regain, and Barkowski angles it off the glass and down the ice.
Keeping the puck along the wall is the key for the Boston Bruins. They don't want to get Toronto set up. Keep their face in the glass. Keep picking it off the wall. You can put pressure on the puck carrier then and get it back down the ice.
Kessel with speed puts on the brakes. Angles it back off the boards now for Dion Phaneuf. Franson toward the net through a crowd, and it was blocked by Dougie Hamilton. Haye got it off the stick of Franson and out to center ice. Now Cody Franson again. Van Riemsdyk hit by Paillet, sends it around. Joffrey Lupo there. Now McQuaid, Kendall on the boards. 45 seconds remaining in the Chara penalty. Phaneuf comes down. Now Van Riemsdyk trying to get some separation from the aggressive Boston penalty kill. Phaneuf now for Kessel, who had gone down but quickly got back up. Hands it off now. Franson fakes. Gets one shot blocker to the ice. Now to Kessel. Tried to redirect the pass. It eventually comes to Phaneuf. Back to Kessel. He waits. Looks. Sends it across. Just missed connecting with Franson. Paillet over on him. Nice job by the Toronto defenseman, though, to keep it alive as Lupo. Now for Kessel. 10 seconds on the power play. It tried by Phaneuf. Save. Rebound. Rask is down. It's score!
Cody Franson puts in a rebound there, moved in from the point, but it's just good old-fashioned hammer it from the point and get a rebound. Tuukka Rask couldn't find it in the pile, and Cody Franson moved in and found it. They go from low to high, get it to number three. There's an alleyway. Now what? Look at Franson off to the side of the net. Everybody thinks on the Boston Bruins that Rask has it just for a moment, but he stopped the initial shot, couldn't handle it. James Van Riemsdyk is the reason why. Van Riemsdyk has his stick in there, gets a good whack at it, loosens it up, and as he's being pushed away from Dougie Hamilton, by Dougie Hamilton, the rebound is put in by Franson. So after a terrific start, physically, puck possession-wise, and everything in the Boston Bruins, it's 1-1.
Cody Franson's second of this series. His third career playoff goal. And what a response by Toronto on the road here in this game seven. Chara for Krejci, who deflects it now into the Toronto zone. Jake Gardner. Gunnarsson plays it around. Kuhlman. Now for Grabowski. Grabowski able to find Clark MacArthur. He puts on the brakes. He's got a late man coming. Decides to wait. Now goes to Kuhlman. And somehow Rask found that through traffic.
Nikolai Kuhlman took a pretty vicious shot from Lucic after that shot, too, and Kuhlman's going to the bench.
Now Lucic, it deflects to Krejci, bunts it ahead now for Nathan Horton, slides it across, and knocked out of the air by Gunnarsson, but still alive in the Toronto zone. Past the halfway mark of this first period of Game 7, Eastern Conference quarterfinal series, Bruins and the Maple Leafs. Angle off the boards, Horton out to the line. Markowski for Horton, a shot doesn't get through. Markowski again will angle it off the corner boards. Krejci in deep. Krejci has had a terrific series with 11 points, tied for the overall league playoff lead. And now the puck taken away by Brett, but his pass is deflected away. Now the Bruins have a 3-on-2. Kelly waits, trying to go to Peverly. It's knocked down, and then Kelly's knocked down.
Great stick by Franzen on that 3-on-2. He intercepted the pass.
Joffrey Lupul across the line. Sends it deep. Colburn. Big collision there. Now Chara. Run into by Orr. Second big hit for Orr on Zdeno Chara. In Van Riemsdyk and Fanuk getting the assist on the goal by Cody Franzen. Here's Colburn. Nearly got it through on the far side. That was Komarov number 47 that was sneaking in. A nifty redirect centering attempt was blocked by the Bruins. Now it comes to the front again. And the Bruins get a stick on it, start it back the other way. Tyler Seguin rolls it in on Reimer, leaves it off for Lyles.
Toronto's done a really good job here of turning the tables after that start by the Bruins. They're getting more and more puck possession and confidence.
Nazem Kadri goes down after getting a shot on goal. Van Riemsdyk with a hit on Marchand, but it's back the other way. Nager had it knocked off his stick. Van Riemsdyk for Kadri. He'll chase in after it, but Boychuk got there first. Kadri with a big hit. Now Bergeron hits the line. Here's Jagr. He gets the shot away into the glove of Reimer, who holds it there. Frantic pace of the first period of Game 7 after an unassisted goal by Barkowski on the power play. The defenseman Cody Franzen has tied the game at 1.
You had the lead. Toronto starting to come back. It's even now. What's important for your team now?
Staying out of the box. There's no doubt. You know, we give them momentum every time we take some penalties here. So if we can stay out of the box 5-on-5 and play the way we know we can, like we did at the beginning, we'll be okay.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Well, the numbers bear it out, and they have for Claude Julien's team, really going back to that cup year, the best 5-on-5 team, usually by far, in the National Hockey League. They were plus 21 5-on-5 scoring in the regular season. They're plus 4 in this series.
Yeah, the year they won the cup, I mean, the power play was good at times, but they went long stretches where it wasn't. You can see his frustration level.
Oh, yeah.
He was working the referees, too, before that interview. There's been a lot of stuff let go already. I think the refs have actually done a good job. They want to let these guys play in a Game 7, too.
John Thornton trying to lift it out of there. Colton Orr went for an open ice hit and just missed Paille as the puck is sent in wide of the Toronto goal, Brian.
Well, he missed half of them, but he got the other half. Paille wasn't happy.
Now slapped away by Orr, who played earlier in his career briefly with the Boston Bruins. There's a couple of connections on these two rosters as O'Byrne steps into his man. Lyles for McClement. Sends it in wide of Rask. Now Rask plays it off the boards. Milan Lucic. Slides it ahead. David Krejci. Hands it off to Nathan Horton. Horton with a shot that was blocked by Fanuk. Now Lucic. That hit a leg and went all the way out to the line. Barkowski now for Lucic again. Sends it back to the right point. Boychuk with a shot, and that just missed wide as Krejci tried to get a stick on it. Now Joffrey Lupul gets to it and lifts it ahead. It's gloved down by Nathan Horton, but it's out to center ice and picked up by the opportunistic Lupul. Barkowski plays him aggressively. Loose puck is picked up by Colburn! And a save made there by Rask out of nowhere. Joe Colburn gets a great chance.
Oh, did he ever. He came in, picked up the loose change after Lupul just got wasted along the boards. The Bruins were a little slow to react. Good thing Rask wasn't.
Here's Gardner with Kessel. Kadri coming late. Gardner with a shot. He had some room high on the stick side. He just fired it too high.
Dave, I don't remember a game seven like this where it was this mean and nasty and openly aggressive physically, because in game sevens you always think we can't take penalties. You heard Claude Julien, if you're going to play this way, and both teams are, then you are going to end up in the penalty box at times unless they cool it down.
Usually guys are a little more conservative in game seven. Marchand trying to cut in. He was angled just enough by Fronson, preventing him from getting to the scoring area he was looking for, as Van Riemsdyk. Nifty little backhand outlet. Here's Kessel. And that goes off the stick of Chara. Jake Gardner moved up on the play. Gardner sends it back now for Lyles. He'll roll it in deep. Kadri had it bounce off his stick. Now Chara for Marchand. And again, it's Jágr out here with Bergeron and Marchand. So far in this first period, now Peverly off the bench picks it up. His shot sails wide of Reimer. And Kuhlman back the other way with MacArthur and Grabowski. A shot into the glove of Tuukka Rask. And he will hold it there. And just like we've had after just about every whistle, a little bit of a scrum there. They break it up. It's 1-1 here in Game 7. Does compete for $50,000 to win the money. They must win over the crowd. Crowd Rules premieres tomorrow on CNBC Prime. Cody Fronson with the power play goal for Toronto.
Dave, during that timeout, both benches, players, at least half the benches on either side, just basically staring each other down. An incredible atmosphere down here. No yelling and screaming, just staring each other down like boxers.
McClement looking to push it along. Bartkowski, who has the Boston goal. Again, the Bruins without Andrew Ferentz. Second game he's missed in a row with an undisclosed injury. There's O'Byrne now. Into the boards by Kelly. Audrey tries to play it up the boards. Kessel backhands it up the near side, but Boychuk held it in at the side of the net. Reimer has the glove on it. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Bacardi. Here's Brian Engblom.
The atmosphere here in this game is terrific, and it was set. The tone was set in the warm-up, I thought, by Zdeno Chara. I watched him and what he did. This was his first shift against Phil Kessel, or running back against him. Chara against Van Riemsdyk, who is not exactly a 5'2", 100-pound guy. He threw him down like he wasn't even there. He has literally dared Toronto Maple Leafs to take one step closer towards the Boston net at time, and he's out there again. I think we're going to see Chara out there for a good 30 minutes in this game here tonight.
Here's Chara, and that's blocked by Kuhlman, who overskates the puck. Gunnarsson back inside his own line. Now for Jake Gardner. A 22-year-old who played 3 years at the University of Wisconsin. And he's jumped into a situation here. There's been injuries on defense for Toronto.
Toronto misses Fraser on defense, who took that nasty shot to the face. So we hope his recovery is going along okay. Gardner comes in to replace him, a completely different kind of player. Cody Fronson, who's played with both of them most of the time, Fronson's had to make some adjustments to play with two very different types of defensemen, and he's done a heck of a job of doing it.
Yeah, Gardner showed last night in a game six that he wasn't afraid to jump in and below the goal line sometimes.
He's a wild Mustang, Dave, no doubt. He's got great wheels. He goes offense. He creates chaos for the Bruins and for his own team sometimes.
Just another great defenseman out of the University of Wisconsin, Brian.
That's right. The list is getting bigger.
Now Colburn backhands it ahead. It'll be chased down by Bartkowski now as Lupo goes in on the forecheck. Bartkowski wraps it around. It's off a stick and recovered here by Lucci. Drops it back, Horton. Far side for Krejci. Settles it down. Rolls it to the front, Horton. And it knocked away by Colburn, who recovered. Now Lucci battling to keep position on Gunnarsson. Then gives Gunnarsson a shove. Now Lucic gets it back from Nathan Horton. Pass out to the line is picked up by Kessel, who has 3 goals in this series, including 2 game winners. Upel sends it far side. Kadri going after it, but Kaye was there. Now Fratton protecting the puck. Rolls it to the corners, and Zdeno Chara sends it back. Angled up the glass and out of play. Well, you can watch live NBC National games on NHL Game Center. Call *NHL to download NHL Game Center and get a free premium upgrade on all tablets and Verizon 4G LTE smartphones.
Randy Carlisle sent different combinations of players out there. Carlisle is a hard matchup guy. It's difficult for him because obviously he is on the road, but he has done that a lot in his coaching career. He really studies the Boston Bruins match. Every time I look over, he's looking up and down to see who he thinks is coming next on their team.
Now Campbell, off his stick, Gardner regains. Here's McClement. Across the line. Maie gets to it, takes a hit from Komarov. And now Sean Thornton for the Bruins. Backhands it across into the Leafs zone. Picked up by Campbell. Slams it along the boards behind the Toronto net. Paille on the far side. Bronson steps into him. Now McClement plays it up the boards. Gardner gets a stick on it. Campbell knocks it down. Crowd was looking for a penalty call there, but nothing coming as it gets by Dougie Hamilton and out to center ice. Bartkowski now sends it in deep. Hammer settles it down. Now Thornton with a steal in the corner. Back out to the point, Zdeno Chara. Hamilton sends it back in deep. Alan Sagan just off the bench as Thornton, the other right winger, was trapped in there deep on the line change. Less than a minute remaining in the period. Sent right through the goal mouth in front of Reimer. Recovered here by Komarov, and Nikolai Kulamin will just drop it back into his own zone as the Leafs regroup. Now MacArthur over skates. Shot was deflected out to the high slot area. Kelly had it taken away. Grabowski with a chance here. Fires it wide of the Boston goal. In deep, Boychuk protects and hands off to Chara. Less than half a minute remaining in the first. Now Chara again angles it off the boards. Tyler Seguin will just lift it safely into the Toronto end. Clock winding down, final 12 seconds of this first period of Game 7. Picking away Bergeron in front, just missed Jágr with that hard pass. And the Leafs come up with it and chip it back out to center ice. And the first period will come to an end. Each team with 12 shots, each team with one goal. There's Cody Fronson, the goal scorer for Toronto on the power play. And Matt Bartkowski, unassisted, the goal scorer for Boston. Stay tuned for the Lexus first intermission report. Russ Taylor and Anson Carter will talk about the tale of two Fronsons and a Game 7 preview of the other Eastern Conference quarterfinal. Game 7 being played tonight down in Washington, D.C. between the Caps and the Rangers. 1-1 here at the end of the first period of Game 7 in Boston. The Lexus first intermission report on the other side of this. Playoffs on CNBC are brought to you by Lexus and the pursuit of perfection. By Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. And by Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Well, Claude Julien told me less than an hour before game time, he said, I've never seen a nervous team win a game seven. We have to come out and be aggressive. They were. As you take a look at the Coors Light cold, hard facts. And the other thing I asked Julien about, are you surprised that your team, which has been the envy of the league for the last couple of years for its balance, has become so top-heavy? Lucic, Krejci, and Horton, ironically, that struggled for long stretches of the regular season, have been so dominant in this series, while the rest of the line's a goal apiece. And he said, yes, he's very much surprised, and that's part of the reason we see Jágr on the line with Bergeron as it comes back now to Bartkowski. Loose puck right in front of the Toronto goal, and it's cleared back the other way. And yeah, the Bruins have kept their top lines together over the last couple of years. Ooh, now that is a tough fall into the boards.
Yes, and Kadri is going to get Boychuk. A penalty. Boychuk is down. Delayed call. Play is going to continue here as Bartkowski now is taken away by Kessel. And Brian, the Bruins can ill afford to have any other defenseman.
That's for sure.
Get hurt.
Boychuk was just kind of clearing his eyes as he came back to the bench here. Going back to the wall anytime you turn and go. Get a little bit off balance here. The ice is that much more slippery at the beginning of a period. It's smooth. There's no way it's going to slow you down. So when he goes down there, he's got absolutely nothing to stop him. He gets tweaked around, shoved off balance, and goes in sideways. And he literally was sort of blinking his eyes as he came back to the bench, but he appears to be okay. Kadri's in the box.
Power play presented by McCarty here for the Boston Bruins, their first in this game seven. As the pass for Jágr off his stick, but he recovers to send it back in deep.
That's a little bit different look, too, with Jágr in the point.
Steele and Sagan couldn't get it on net as it was blocked. Now it comes to Tyler Sagan again. Angles it off the boards, looking for his first point of this series. Now Lucic. Off a skate and off the stick of Chara out to center ice. Chara has it again. Jágr across the line. Hands it off for Lucic. Bergeron straight away shot that was blocked right in front of Zdeno Chara.
Kuhlman got right in the shooting lane.
Jágr sends it across. Sagan drops it down for Nook. Did not play it out of the zone. It's controlled by the Bruins. 55 seconds remaining in the penalty. To Nazem Kadri, who went out for interference. Chara straight away with a shot that goes up over the glove, and now it is cleared to the line. Chara again. One time by Sagan. Put it up high off the glass. And now Kuhlman will send it all the way back down the ice. And it hit somebody in the bench. Yes, it did.
Gunderson had a chance to get that puck out of the zone, and he shot it right at Chara. And Chara kept it in and got that second chance. His first shot, the puck flipped up on him. That's why he lost control of it. Gunderson spinning around, just throw it out of the zone, and inadvertently puts it right back to Chara. Chara's smart. The lane had closed in front of him, so he got it off onto the angle for the one-time shot. Another second chance. Sagan pulled the trigger. Boston moved the puck around decently on that power play.
Now cleared around and all the way down the ice by number four, Cody Franson. And thanks to a few people on Twitter, and I did some checking, I got a bad scoop on the pronunciation of number four's name. I thought it might have been the Medano thing that we hear, the difference between Canadian and American broadcasters, because I thought I had heard his name pronounced Franson with an S, not a Z, like Johan Franson, but they do prefer Cody Franson. And so we want to get it right. That's what we'll go with. Now Marchand, who is sometimes called Marchand in Canada, sends it back the other way. And David Krejci now has it. Rutkowski plays it ahead. Deep into the Toronto zone. Fratton sends it back. Franson will pick it up there. The Leafs safely out with it now. Now Colburn didn't get across the red line. Neutral zone turnover. Campbell looks to the front. Goes off the pad of Reimer and picked up by Colburn on the far side. He'll start it back. Here's Fratton now. Trying to cut in on Barkowski. Broke it up and he gets a shot away. And Rask the save.
Fratton's got really slick hands. He'll try things like that. He's trying Barkowski, who hasn't played as much as a lot of the other Boston defensemen, and he'll have to play more now because we haven't seen hardly anything of Seidenberg.
Now Barkowski angles it off the boards. Gregory Campbell. He will play it deep into the Maple Leaf zone. Gardner back to play. Hands it off now for John Michael Lyles. Fratton, right wing side, goes rink wide with speed. Here comes Gardner. Loves to jump into the play. And Kadri, big hit there from McQuaid. Now Jágr across the line. Marchand turns, hands it off. Jágr to the front. And all the way to the far boards. And it's picked up now by Marchand, but not for very long. Kadri took it away, and it's back the other way for Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk cutting in with speed. Couldn't go to the backhand. Did a good job of avoiding Tuukka Rask, too, which may have drawn a penalty. And back comes Marchand the other way. Trying to go through three players. Drops it back into Jágr. One-timer there by Bergeron. It was in his feet. And it's covered up and presented by Progressive. Let's go inside the glass. Here's Brian.
Well, Boston's in a tough situation because they're down to five defensemen. Dennis Seidenberg only played two shifts, 37 seconds in the first period. Number 44 going into the boards there, leg first, and then that was his next play. You could see him on his bench after that. favoring that left leg. He is sitting there. We haven't seen him yet, but Boston's had to rotate five guys. That means certainly that Zdeno Chara's ice time is going to go up. Good thing he's in tremendous shape. All of these guys are. Back-to-back games again, of course. These two teams played last night in Toronto.
Ooh, nearly played there by Reimer in the no-touch zone. But up the right wing side, Colton Orr able to protect the puck. Slides it out. Sagan hands it off now. Here's Boychuk on a rush the other way. Gunnarsson plays it up the boards. Heverly blocks it. Here's Chris Kelly. Tyler Sagan had it poked away before he could make a play. 5 minutes gone by here in the second period. 1-1 in game seven. Off the skate of Orr and out to center ice. Barkowski hammers it around on the far side. McClement came off his stick in a strange way. He gets it back. Hands it off to Orr. Look out. Chara stepped up and bumped him. But the Maple Leafs get it back. Komarov rolls it in on Tuukka Rask and now Dougie Hamilton for Zdeno Chara. Top scoring defenseman in these playoffs. The late offside here against the Bruins will wave it off as Lucic got out and Mark MacArthur turns it back the other way. Grabowski angled to the boards by Hamilton. MacArthur, nice feed out to the right point. Francis with the drive, he scores! Cody Francis will have his second goal of this game seven, and the Maple Leafs have a 2-1 lead.
Talk about the guy with the magic touch. Cody Franson with this shot from the point, the puck flips up a little bit. So it has a real different look going at Tuukka Rask. Yeah, there was a screen in front, there usually is, but see if you can pick it up when Franson shoots from the point. He'll stop it and shoot it. And anytime you hit a puck that's on edge or rolling a little bit, it just has a little bit of a different look. His delivery was terrific. He sort of disguised it. You can see that the trajectory that it took, and it went underneath the arm of Zdeno Chara. That's the thing when you come out and you try to block shots and you don't block them. Your goaltender is at your mercy, and Tuukka Rask just never saw that one after it got by Chara.
Branson, originally a Nashville Predators pick back in 05, came to the Leafs on a deal along with Matthew Lombardi to set Lebda and Slaney back the other way. And first couple of years played entirely in the American League in Milwaukee, but he is making his presence felt here in this game seven. Grabowski got an assist along with MacArthur. Chance in front here. Reimer the save as Gregory Campbell gets a great opportunity to get the equalizer. Reimer, terrific the last two games, allowing one goal in each. Keeps it at 2-1.
Mikhail Grabowski on the forecheck gets it to MacArthur, and MacArthur will get it back to the point to Franson. Now watch how he disguises this shot a little bit. He looked like he was shooting for one side of the net and then pulled it to the other side. It also obviously went off the arm or the inside of the hand of Zdeno Chara, who was trying to make the block, and it made it no chance for Tuukka Rask.
No icing here as Barkowski back to get it. Was flattened in on the forecheck, but it's quickly cleared out to center ice. Milan Lucic will send it deep. Cody Franson with a pair of goals. Boy, one thing we know about game sevens, Brian, they can very often deliver a hero that's unexpected. Now Boychuk, pinned to the boards by Lupo. Lupo had it taken away. Krejci sends it along the boards, and Lucic now bumped off the puck by Kuhlman. Now Grabowski looks across. MacArthur centering attempt was blocked. Barkowski back to get it. Hanson held it in. Now MacArthur looks again out front. Got hit. Oh, what a save by Rask. Got Jake Gardner, and another nice pass to the point by Clark MacArthur.
MacArthur good along the wall again, and yeah, the defense getting involved for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Gardner, who's got excellent offensive skills, he has moved right in the prime scoring area in the slot.
Wow.
He pulled the trigger on that one quickly. That is a terrific save by Tuukka Rask. That is labeled low for the corner. But yeah, Clark MacArthur doing a terrific job of coming up with loose pucks along the wall and then getting his head up and getting it back to the point for some open shots.
Now Kessel tried to push it deep. It's blocked by McQuaid. His stretch pass doesn't connect. Going to be icing. Branson got there just ahead of Jaromir Jagr. Stay tuned for a lot more Stanley Cup coverage. I want to remind you, another Game 7 in progress right now over on the NBC Sports Network, the Rangers and Capitals in Washington. Tomorrow we'll have Game 1 of the Eastern Conference Semifinal Series between the Penguins and the Ottawa Senators. That'll be followed by Game 1 of a Western Conference Semifinal. All California, LA and San Jose beginning at 10 Eastern. Here it is, 2-1 Toronto. Trying to come back from a 3-1 series deficit for the first time since 1942 when that Toronto team came back from a 3-0 deficit. Shot here deflected in front. And Reimer picking a little spin-a-ram on his pads. After that puck sailed through the crease area, now around the boards. Kara moves down for the point. Hands it off. The three Bergeron centering pass, Jagr sent it wide. Now Jagr again digs it out of there. Wanted to hand it off for Marchand, but it's picked off, and Lionel Byrne will send it ahead for Van Riemsdyk, who sent it into the Boston zone. Rask. Now Marchand, far side. Tyler Seguin with speed, circling the net, angles it off the boards. Now it's chipped by Kessel and out to center ice. Jara for Peverly. Has to play it ahead. It's blocked by Franson and back the other way. Jara bumped there by Lupo. Leafs still taking every opportunity to run into number 33. Not an enviable task, but trying to wear down the big guy that they know is going to play a lot of minutes anyway, and even more so with a short bench, as this is an icing call against Toronto.
Cody Franson's been in the middle of everything for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Turning the puck over along the wall there, which led to the Boston Bruins goal. And then moving up on the power play, the puck comes loose, and he is right there, the defenseman on the edge of the crease on that power play. And then the big blast from the point. I really like, I found that delivery on that second goal that he scored very interesting, because he looked like he was aiming for one side of the net and just kind of pulled it. I think it surprised more than a few people. He got a lot on it because of it too. He's had a terrific game here. Big influence on it.
Now Lucic out to the line. Barkowski rolls it in deep. David Krejci has Horton in front, of the pass hits the back of the net. Colburn being very physical with Krejci as the puck is sent back the other way. And McQuaid knows he has to hustle with Joffrey Lupo there. Domoski hands it off. Circling the net, Coleman, and just getting up against that post on the glove side was Tuukka Rask.
The quickness of the Leafs now really starting to take over in this game. Boston's on the defensive here, spending more and more time inside their own zone. It's the forecheck, and again, Grabowski doing a really good job. He did the initial grunt work on that goal by Cody Franson, because he got in there and turned the puck over and pushed it over to MacArthur before he got it back to the net. That time, Grabowski again loosening it up and getting a chance for Kuhlman on the attempted wraparound.
Marchand angles it off the boards. Put up, slides it across. Now Kuhlman. Rubbed down by Marchand, and Bergeron clears it ahead. Kelly just out of his reach. Chara and Dougie Hamilton, the combination out here now for Claude Julien, as another icing here against the Maple Leafs. We approach the halfway mark of the second period, and Brian, does it appear down there that the game has just kind of settled in a little bit, slowed down from that intense start that we had?
Yes, there is no doubt about that. Both teams are certainly worried about taking penalties. Claude Julien talked about it. You don't want to give the other team, obviously, goals on the power play, which Boston has given away one already. But it's also about puck possession and having your top line guys getting the feel for the puck more and more. That's dangerous to work against you. So you have to be careful not to take penalties here. So I think both teams have settled in a little bit more. They're picking their spots. It's not recklessly physical the way it was for most of the first period.
Neither team controls the draw cleanly. Jágr, while he's on the seat of his pants, still trying to make a play down to the corner. Now it's cleared back out to center ice. Bartkowski, who has the Boston goal. Grabowski. Looked like he got away with grabbing a hold of Bartkowski, then lost his stick. Heads back to the bench as an icing call here against the Bruins. You can download the NBC Sports Live Extra app to watch the game live on your phone or tablet, plus have access to live chats with experts from Pro Hockey Talk. The NBC Sports Live Extra app on NBCSports.com/live extra and NHL.com.
On the forecheck again. That's an interesting play. That was Grabowski again in on the forecheck. Toronto really starting to use some foot speed here.
Jágr fires it over the glove. Now a centering pass. Franson is there, and he sends it back the other way. Going to be another icing here. And another faceoff down to the Leafs' end.
Just clearing the zone, making sure you get out of it. And the danger, obviously, is faceoffs. And in game one, the Toronto Maple Leafs won the faceoff battle just by a little bit. Ever since then, Boston has really taken over in that department, as they have during the regular season as well, too. So a steady diet of faceoffs and you're in for Toronto is not a good thing.
They've now won 17 of 24 in this game with that win, as Reimer covers up on the blast from Hamilton past the halfway mark of this second period. Game seven for Boston, and it's the Leafs leading the Bruins 2-1.
Really kind of wildly physical in the first period. Did you want to curtail that a little bit, worried about getting penalty?
I thought that they were going to come with their first 5 minutes. They were going to give everything they've got, and they tried to get their crowd going, and they did a pretty good job of it. But we weathered the storm, and then we got ourselves back into it with a big power play goal.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Randy Carlyle, who was behind the bench for the Anaheim Ducks when they won a Stanley Cup in 07, was out of work all of about 3 months after he was let go in Anaheim back in November of 2011, and replaced Ron Wilson behind the bench in Toronto back in March of 2012. As this puck comes right in front of the Toronto net, off a stick, and the Bruins recover. Heverly hands it off below the goal line, sent out in front. Van Riemsdyk hammers it to the corner. Sagan gives it back to Peverly. Out to the line, Zdeno Chara rolls it across Dougie Hamilton. Here's a shot knocked down in front. Who gets a stick on it first, under control? And Dion, the Leafs able to clear Van Riemsdyk, but no, the long reach of Chara.
Dion Phaneuf is hurt. He is limping badly, trying to get back to the Toronto Maple Leaf bench. I think he got that shot from a point.
And he goes right down the tunnel, Brian. Saw him go to the end of the bench with a forward sit.
Well, he eats up big minutes, too, against all the top players. That's a big loss. He's out long for Toronto.
And in wide of Tuukka Rask. No icing here. Angled off the boards. Kessel gets a stick on it. Now Thornton slides it across. Here is Peverly. And that play is just offside at the Toronto blue line.
Last shift out for Dion Phaneuf in front of the net. There was a lot of traffic. Boston was able to get the shots through to the front. Watch number three in front, just jockeying for position. Inside of the leg, inside of the right leg, right inside the knee possibly, like the general area. He had good inside position against Sagan, which is what you want, between him and the net, making sure they had Sagan tied up. And you see he went down there very heavily. He was limping badly to the bench.
Bartkowski back the other way. And it's deflected off the glass. Bouncing puck. Crowd reacting to Campbell's hit. As Reimer has to make a save. Wrapped in front by Campbell. Recovered by the Leafs. And Jay McClendon starts it back into the Boston zone, or tried to. Denied by Paille, who then checks him hard right into his own bench. And this play just offside at the Bruins' blue line.
Interesting the way this game has gone for the Boston Bruins. They set the tone. Randy Carlyle talked about it. You knew they were going to come out hard. Bruins really running at Toronto. Toronto ran back at them. And the interesting thing for Randy Carlyle's guys, they led the National Hockey League in hits and in block shots and in fights. that one of the things that they did was they changed the culture of Toronto for sure. They played very physically. They've intimidated and run over different teams during the course of this short season. They weren't going to be intimidated by Boston. They just wanted to stand up to it in the early stages. They have done that. And really now it's their legs and their forecheck that have really taken the game away from Boston a little bit here.
Gunnarsson back with Lutic right on him. Lutic with a hard hit on Gunnarsson into the boards. Now out to the point. Hamilton across for Chara with a shot here. Missed the net. MacArthur gets to it and works it out to center ice. Grabowski takes it wide on Hamilton. Taken down and now Krejci slides it across. Horton back for Lutic. Just missed connecting and there's Dion Phaneuf right back at it.
And he made a great play at the net there, lifting Lucic's stick right away. Lucic right back after Dion Phaneuf. Well, he wants the goal.
Well, Phaneuf gave him a stick in the back of the leg as Lucic was skating away. And now Lucic, I think, is getting the only penalty. He wants to be careful that he doesn't get more than the two he's going to get.
Yeah, that's for sure. He's really pushing the envelope here. Dion Phaneuf just stood back and took it. It started behind the net. Dion Phaneuf came back and he wasn't limping, that's for sure. When he went to the front of the net with Lucic, the stick-on-stick work was terrific and probably prevented a goal. Lucic was going there waiting for Horton to pass him the puck. Watch Dion Phaneuf. There's the play I'm talking about. Then they go behind the net. There's the first little shove. Phaneuf goes down, comes around, just
right
gives
there.
Him a slap on the back. You know, it was far from vicious. I mean, he just slapped him. It wasn't exactly a big deal. Phaneuf knows that Lucic is tough. Phaneuf can go too, no doubt about that. But Phaneuf was smart there. Lucic pushed it one too many times. A lot of times you'll see both players go there. That's a big loss. This is a big penalty kill here for Boston.
Boston continues to dominate in the faceoff circle. Kelly back the other way shorthanded. Branson with both of the Toronto goals, including one on a power play. This Maple Leaf power play is presented by Husqvarna. Marchand trying to make a play. Make it back by Van Riemsdyk. Stood up on the line by Boychuk. Shots were 12-12, Brian, at the end of one. They are now 17-13. Five shots for Toronto, one for Boston in this second period of a game seven on Boston ice.
Well, it's the forecheck. Toronto's done a terrific job in this second period of it.
Bergeron throws it across the tent here, fired wide! Paille with a great chance shorthanded.
Toronto went to sleep. Paille all alone. Bergeron, so smart to see him.
Branson finally gets control. And Caprio started back the other way. Able to find Grabowski on the near board. Sandwich between a couple of Boston defenders. Now the puck comes free. Grabowski, great pass across. Wiles with a shot. And the save made by Rask.
Boy, what a shorthanded goal would have done. Mikhail Grabowski with a little extra pushing and shoving. Is he going to end up with two minutes here? Yeah, it looks like he might. Let's go back to the shorthanded chance, though. Toronto goes to sleep a little bit. On the rush here, Marchand. And then Bergeron with the puck. Marchand went for a line change. That's why Toronto went to sleep on the play. Paille came off the bench, and because he was on the bad angle, he tried to go far side. Now, this is the way this last series of events ended in front of the net. This is the kind of stuff, though, that coaches get crazy about. It's the stuff after the whistles where you end up in the penalty box that makes the difference between winning and losing. That is not a good penalty to take for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Well, each team gets a man in the box.
Campbell pushing and shoving there, that kind of stuff. The referees, you know, are going to clamp down at some point. You saw what happened in the Lucic Dion Phaneuf encounter. Lucic went alone. That time they took both players.
Well, that's what I think Claude Julien's upset about. If you're only going to take one on the previous situation, why do you take both there? Another face-off win by the Boston Bruins. Brian, they have won 24 face-offs out of 31 in this game. Maple Leafs have only won 7 draws.
Yeah, they've always been good. And I think Bozak's one of their better ones for Toronto. He's not in the lineup, still hurt.
again. We haven't seen Seidenberg since his first 37 seconds of ice time of the first period. Kessel with a shot that's blocked.
At 14:27.
Gardner across. Lyles. Now for Lupo. Hands it off down low for Kessel. Lupo tries to wrap it in front. Toronto player got knocked down. Oh, and then
Tuukka-Rask lost his mask.
Punch. A punch to the face of Joffrey Lupo after he lost his mask, so the officials have to stop play.
That's why Rask threw the punch. Lupo was pushed into the paint, I believe, by Sedano Chara. There was a pileup, and in the collision, Rask's mask came off. That's why he was angry.
Goaltenders like to protect their crease. There goes the helmet. There goes the blocker. Lupo peeling it. But the Leafs with the lead. Back here at TD Garden in Boston, Game 7, Eastern Conference Quarterfinals. Series tied at 3. Leafs leading this Game 7 by a score of 2-1. Tuukka-Rask just took issue with Joffrey Lupo, ending up in his crease and in his net.
He's got a pretty good right cross with that blocker.
Yes, he does. Lucic bounced off the skate, goes back deep into the Boston zone. Matt Barkowski has it there. He started the scoring at 5:39, unassisted goal. And then Cody Franson has scored the last two for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Pass here for Lucic. He missed on the centering attempt. And now it's pushed back out to the line and recovered here by the Leafs. Komarov back to the line. Gunnarsson tried to send it along the boards, but it's blocked in. Did not connect with Lucic. Lucic with a big hit on Gunnarsson as the puck back into the Boston zone. Panuk couldn't clear, intercepted. Gagner with a shot, hit the side of the net.
Good timing there by Yager. He was in good defensive position just outside the blue line when Panuk backhanded up the wall. He was there.
Marchand centering pass was broken up. Bratton a little self-chip off the boards. Working against Dougie Hamilton, who pushes into the corner and then pushes Bratton right into the Boston goal. And back the other way now, Cody Franson backing up. Redirected ahead. Bratton now for Lupo. Brings it along the boards far side. Yager trying to clear. Gardner holds it in. Gardner. Where Kadri missed on the one-timer. Franson, though, and that's into the glove. Cody Franson comes close again.
Brad Marchand with a good play in the middle of the ice, though. It was his stick that prevented the scoring opportunity from the slot, and the puck went off the wall, and Franson was able to get it off the wall and shoot the puck towards the net. There's the play into the middle. There's the stick by Marchand. And Franson comes in. Boy, is he the right place, right time, magic touch guy or what?
Yeah, he's been unbelievable.
Franson.
Yep.
Marchand has been really involved in this game. Franson's a big guy. I mean, he's got a good shot. He's got a good grasp, certainly, of the offensive game. He makes really good plays. He's played very steady physically. His most glaring mistake of the game was really in his first shift where he tried to stand up in the zone and gave up the 2-on-1 to Krejci.
Now Peverly puts on the brakes inside the Toronto zone. Eye slot for Kelly, gets through him and out to center ice. Couple of players go down. And Riemsdyk. And then taking an elbow there from Kelly. They were engaged with each other. And
there's no maybe about it.
It was, okay. You had a much better look at it, Brian.
Van Riemsdyk is not happy, and he's talking to referee Brad Watson, like, what happened there? We were just getting up peacefully and nicely away from the play, and then all of a sudden, I got a mouthful of his elbow pad. They've been all over Van Riemsdyk in this game for good reason. He had two assists in the last game. It'll happen right there in the middle of your screen. Van Riemsdyk pushes down Kelly. They'll stay kind of wrapped around each other, and it just got a little messy and ugly as they were getting up. And
wow,
that is an ugly shot to the head, all right. You could see it even from that high an angle. Van Riemsdyk, he wanted a four-minuter, you could tell, because you could see he's bleeding from the nose.
Lucic off the board. That was blocked up high on the glass.
That was Kuhlman. Great stick by Kuhlman.
Now Chara Trying to keep control for Lucic off his stick. And McClemmon clears it ahead. Grabowski now for Kuhlman. That's chopped away. Kuhlman loses his stick. Picks it up and then heads to the bench as the Leafs will make a change. Just over 2 minutes remaining here in the second period. With one goal in the second period. That was Cody Franson at 5:48. MacArthur. And that's right into the glove of Tuukka Rask. He will hold it there.
The Boston Bruins set the tone in this game right off the bat. They came out, they were smoking everything. Chara was right in the middle of most of it. There he is against Van Riemsdyk, down low in front of the net. Lucic against Dion Phaneuf, down low in front. Even the goaltender with a good right cross to Joffrey Lupul's chops. They've gotten nailed a couple of times. Chara spent 2 minutes in the penalty box. Van Riemsdyk has been whacked around big time, but he's still hanging in there. We got another penalty. Going to be Toronto for a trip.
Right off the faceoff, yep.
Keep your feet moving and good things will happen. That's what the coaches will tell you. Looks like Joffrey Lupul headed to the penalty box. Off the faceoff, Randy Carlyle not happy. The faceoff win by Boston and Marchand just tries to carry it through. Carlyle's arguing that Lupul just trying to make a play on the puck. Marchand obviously went down. It's a tripping call and the faceoff comes back to Toronto's zone.
Kuhlman sends it back the other way. Power play number two for the Boston Bruins. They trail this game 7-2-1. Taken away by McClemmon. He sends it all the way back down behind Tuukka Rask.
They acquired Jay McClemmon specifically for penalty kill, which was horrible last year for Toronto. He's done a really good job and a backbone of them improving quite dramatically this year.
Now Lucic hands it off in the corner. Jagr back to Lucic. Lucic trying to walk out in front. Good stick there. Komarov got a stick on it. Now it's cleared all the way back down the ice. One minute remaining in the second, Brian.
Boston not attacking with very much speed here. I think they're going to have to, now they're trying a little speed with Marchand. That should drive it in the zone better.
He takes it all the way to the end boards. Now angles it. Across now for Krejci. Out to the line. Hamilton. Everly looking to the front. Goes off a stick to the near boards. Krejci has it again. Marchand back to Krejci. Half a minute left in the period. Right to the front tip. Loose puck. Backhanded by Marchand. And Reimer kept it out of there. Back to the line. Hamilton rolls it across for Krejci. Pressured by McClemmon. Good keep in there by Hamilton. Krejci down low. Now Krejci again. Aerial pass out to Hamilton. Shot deflected. Kuhlman couldn't get a stick out of here. Krejci again. 5 seconds left in the period. Down low. Centering pass. And this misfiring there was Marchand. It comes out to the point, but time is going to run out before Krejci even let that shot go. James Reimer and the Maple Leafs will head to the second intermission of Game 7 with Cody Franson's second goal of the game, the difference right now. The Discover Card second intermission report coming up. Russ Dale, Ranson Carter. Talk about Franson continuing to shine and highlights of the Rangers Capitals Game 7, which is underway in our nation's capital. 2-1 Toronto. Who will be the hero of this Game 7? The Leafs with a 2-1 lead. The Stanley Cup playoffs on CNBC are brought to you by Verizon, the official wireless partner of the NHL. And by Bacardi. Bacardi reminds you to enjoy the game and party together responsibly. Back in downtown Boston, you can sense the tenseness here as who is going to come up offensively for the Bruins. Will it be a guy like Jagr? Milan Lucic, who's been strong throughout this series. His line has accounted for 9 of the Boston goals coming in Or will Brad Marchand, or perhaps one of his line mates, get their first goal?
Tremendous pressure on this Boston team right now, because this upstart Toronto team is feeling it. You can see the enthusiasm they came out and just sat down on their bench with, Dave.
Third period underway as Bunup hammers it back into the Boston zone. Hamilton, Vachara, again the Bruins lost the defenseman early in the game. Seidenberg, here's Marchand with a chance, saved by Reimer, and the puck is cleared.
Oh, what a nice move by Marchand, pulling that puck in close to him and then zipping that wrist shot. Reimer just had to fight that one off.
Loose in front, MacArthur fanned on it.
That was a terrific forecheck by Komarov again. He just trapped Chara in the corner and turned the puck over shorthanded.
Now here is Boychuk sending it back into the Toronto zone. Branson just shielding the puck away from Jágr. Here is Gardner. Sends it off the boards and down the ice, and this will be icing here against Toronto.
Brad Marchand's got some terrific hands. He hasn't been able to find the back of the net in this series. Look at this cute little move here. That is really nice. Creates some time and room for himself, and he got everything on that little wrist shot. Reimer just knocked it down, even though he used his glove to do it. Marchand and the Bruins need more of that.
Bruins had 7 shots in the first, 6 in the second. Barkowski, who has the only goal, sent it wide after another faceoff win. That's the one area that Boston has totally dominated, better than 80% of the draws in this game. The Bruins have controlled as a shot here skips into the glove of James Reimer. And the 25-year-old from Manitoba will hang on to it.
The Toronto Maple Leafs over the last couple of years could not play against the Boston Bruins. Clark MacArthur was very frank about it the other day. He said, last year, it was awful. We would just lay down in front of them. It wasn't going anywhere. They just took it to us. We just decided this year, we're done with that. It's over. And they have shown that. Especially the last 2 games leading up to this one with the 2 victories, you can tell they have put that behind them.
Same score up on the board that we've seen in each of the last 2 games, 2-1 in favor of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Skips off the stick of Barkowski, save made by Rask. And the Bruins dodge a bullet there as they control now. Boychuk out of his own zone.
Too slow, too deliberate with the puck. They've done it sometimes on their power play. Now they're shaking a little bit, not moving the puck quickly from the defense up to the forwards and creating that north-south speed.
Krejci tries to get it to the front, and it was picked off by Kadri, who's run into as he comes out of his own zone on the far side. Kessel. Lucic gets there now. Kessel getting some help from Van Riemsdyk. Turns, shoots up high, save, rebound, hit the post, it's score! Kessel on the rebound! Bill Kessel makes it 3-1!
Hanging around at the right place, right on the edge of the crease, Phil Kessel has finally come out from that shadow that's been over him ever since he got traded to Toronto. Cashed in for his 4th goal now against the Boston Bruins in this series. And again, hard on the forecheck, turning pucks over. And it's Kessel that does it. Toronto gets it, loops around, they have time and space. Kessel went around behind the net. It was almost poked in by Kadri in the first place. Kadri had a chance and he hit the goalpost. Boston reactionary, not on top of the puck, not sharp with the puck. And there's Kessel using the back of the net. That's the easiest goal he's scored all year.
Now Gardner, for Franson, who sends it ahead. It bounces off the stick of Fratton and recovered here by Chara. A stunned TD Garden crowd. Bill Kessel, you talk about the struggles that you just were speaking of with Clark MacArthur being very frank about it. Nobody has been the focal point of those struggles more than Phil Kessel, the former first-round pick of the Bruins here. Kessel with a shot, Reimer the save. And it's backhanded by Gardner around the boards, held in by Chara. Kelly knocked down by Franson. Jumps right back up, no call coming. And the puck rolls back into the Boston zone. Dougie Hamilton has it there. Now Bartkowski with it. Andre and Van Riemsdyk, the assist on that last goal. As that shot by Kelly whistled high. Now Campbell jumps on it. Leaves it around Paille, waiting on the near side, lets it go to the line. McQuaid shot goes in wide. Now Bartkowski hands it off down low for Campbell. Bruins scored the first goal of this game. The Leafs have scored the last three, the most recent by Phil Kessel. John Thornton sends it back to the front. Here Campbell puts it right in front. Chance here, knocked down. I'm not sure if it was Reimer or MacArthur that blocked it in front, but what a chance for the Bruins fourth line there to get one back.
Terrific forecheck. The Bruins turning things around there. Thornton unhappy, coming to the bench, slams the stick. He had a terrific chance. I couldn't see from here whether it got through to Reimer either. But there's Thornton just throwing it to the net. Bruins right on top of it. That's Campbell getting it into the paint. And then there comes Thornton.
Yeah.
I think Reimer did get a glove up on that one. He was sort of falling forward there. He still is recovering. Oh. He was surfing in the net there, face down. He got up and he used his glove and batted that one away.
He has made some incredible saves in this series.
Pure instinct and reaction in a desperate situation, and Thornton just couldn't find the back of the net.
Now Jágr knocked off his stick by Grabowski, and Grabowski lifts it back out through center ice.
Boston just not sharp there, Dave. There was a chance. You got a icing call here. Hamilton trying to make the quick up to Marchand on a Toronto line change, but the pass wasn't there.
Well, here's the Kessel we talked about during the regular season. 3 goals in 22 games, no game winners since the 2009 trade against Boston. All three of those goals, by the way, were on the power play. He hadn't scored at even strength until this series. He's got 4 goals now here in 7 games, a couple of game winners. And he has scored at even strength.
He got big support from the crowd in Toronto the other night. The crowd was taunting Sagan instead of Kessel. That was a nice feeling for him for a change the first time. Boston trying to loosen things up here with a couple of long stretch passes, trying to create some gaps there between the forwards and defense of Toronto. Colton Orr pretty active on the bench there for the Toronto Maple Leafs against Brad Marchand as he skated by. Although this game has, because of the seriousness of the situation, they've been more careful about how they've been going at each other, especially after the faceoff, after the whistle.
Well, Julian talked about the Jekyll and Hyde nature of this team all season, and that the good addition of the Boston Bruins had to show up for this one. They did initially, and now they find themselves down by 2 with just over 15 remaining. Another Sagan. Franson takes him to the boards. Now Krejci out to the line. McQuaid didn't see a shooting lane. Now Chara protecting it away from Gardner. Wanted to go to Krejci. Leafs got a stick on that. Back to the line. Milan Lucic with a shot. And that was blocked by Kessel.
Good stick in the shooting lanes. I think it's smart of Chara. Here comes Chara again. Very aggressive. He represents a lot for the Bruins. I think he's got to step up offensively.
And now it creates a two-on-one the other way. Another chance. Rebound. Score! Kessel shot. Rebound. Kadri. And it is a 4-1 Toronto lead.
Wow. So much time for the Leafs here on this two-on-one. Chara did jump up, but the Boston Bruins forward didn't fill in and read the play properly. Chara comes in. Then Krejci steps up on the play when he shouldn't have. He should have been back taking Chara's place. A really smart shot by Phil Kessel. Kessel's looking low on the far side, and there was room. I was looking right over his shoulder. I almost thought that original shot was going to go in. It was a really good save initially by Tuukka Rask, but he has to kick the rebound out, and Nazem Kadri's timing is perfect, and he has virtually the empty net to shoot it into.
Nazem Kadri, 7th overall pick back in 2009, has paid his dues in the minor leagues for the Toronto Maple Leafs. 3-goal Toronto lead. Again, 1942, the last time a Toronto Maple Leaf team trailed the series 3-1 and came back to win it. That series, they trailed 3-0.
Look at Grabowski in on the forecheck again. That guy is like a dog on the scent. He just keeps going and going. And he's been run over about 3 or 4 times just in this game alone. And several times in this series, nothing seems to bother Grabowski.
Kessel and Gardner on the assist as Fratton sends it back to the line. Gardner with it. Now chased down along the boards. Grabowski kept off the puck, but here's Joffrey Lupo with it, who has scored a Game 7 overtime goal in his career with the Philadelphia Flyers. Excellent work by the Leafs in the offensive zone. Even if the puck's on the perimeter, Brian, they're...
Textbook.
Yep.
Textbook cycling. Keep the puck in the offensive zone, 200 feet away from your own goal. Puck possession.
And the clock keeps moving. Here's Lupo with a shot that goes wide of Tuukka Rask. Now a bouncing puck out in front of the Boston goal. Bruins get to it. Haye. And starts it back the other way. Broken up at the line by John Michael Lyles. Orr drops it back. If the Leafs hang on here, Brian, they take on the winner of the Capitals Rangers Game 7, which is going on right now over on the NBC Sports Network. And last look, the Rangers continue to lead 1-0 on an Aaron Asham goal.
All the players in that game, just like here, fatigue becomes a factor now, having played last night in Toronto for these two teams. And when you are winning, which Toronto is, they don't show signs of fatigue at all. But you can see Boston is really starting to labor. I mean, it's the mental fatigue that's hurting them now, down a couple.
Dodger centering pass, redirected from backhanded just over the glove of Reimer by Bergeron as a shot from the line by McQuaid misses everything. Now Kuhlman able to tip it off the boards and back inside the Boston line.
Toronto rotating their lines very well, too. A lot of guys getting ice time and getting the job done.
Here's Barkowski with a chance, and that just sailed over top of the net. Now McQuaid for the Bruins. Marchand turns, hands it off. Jágr trying to create something. Back to the line, one-timer, missed the net. That was McQuaid trying to set up. Perhaps Bergeron in front.
I think it went off of Bergeron and went just wide. He had a good screen going. That's the way things have gone offensively for Bruins.
Jágr gets to it again. Off the boards now, Barkowski. Back pass for McQuaid. Hands it off on the corner. Marchand, nice move there off of him. And that may have gone off the crossbar after he tried to go high on the short side. And now it's covered up in the crease. And Nazem Kadri is down in front of his goaltender. But Kadri was a factor at the other end. After Kessel scored, he set up Kadri, and it is now a 4-1 lead. Frustration here in Beantown. James Reimer, boy, has he been a huge factor throughout this series, but in particular games 5, 6, and 7 so far, giving up just one goal in each of the games. Just under 11 minutes remaining in this game 7, but now Reimer has a 3-goal cushion as Lucic looks to the front, gets it out front, a shot here, score! Nathan Horton buries one with 10:42 remaining. The Bruins back to within 2.
Milan Lucic coming back to the bench saying, come on, let's go, let's get it going. Lucic on the attack there, was given some room and some time. He just carries it. Say, if you can't get to the front of the net, get to the back of the net. He does, he has room and time. Horton found the soft spot. He's been the hottest Bruin in this series. He backs off, gets a little bit of room. It's on his forehand right away. He has to fish for it a little bit, and then he makes the shot as Reimer had to protect that near side post. And then you see the problem he has going from right to left, back to right again. Good shot by Horton, and a little bit of movement here for Boston.
As you mentioned, Brian, is fourth of this series. Scored in the first 3 games, as a matter of fact. And and a couple of assists in game four, but gets a huge goal here. Gets the crowd back buzzing a bit. And a little bit of life. As Claude Julien comes out with this fourth line, that's had some good shifts. Campbell off the boards with it. Paye sends it back in deep. Angle off the boards now for Boychuk. He sends a shot toward the net. It misses high and wide. Quentin gets to it. And Colburn will send it back down into the Boston zone.
The execution on their chances has just been better for Toronto than it has been for the Boston Bruins. Bruins, until that shot, looked like they were just desperate to try and find a way to find that back of the net. Makes you think of that first shift of the game for Krejci when he had that two-on-one.
Yeah.
And he couldn't put it in the back of the net, how that would have changed the momentum. The big save by Reimer to set the tone for the game.
Here comes Krejci again. Drops it off, a drive, save, rebound opportunity is swept to the board.
Lucic, what a shot by Lucic, low glove side. Great save, Reimer.
Chara without a helmet. Heads back to the bench. Blocked at the line by Gardner. Hands it off now for Kessel. Kessel tries to roll it to the front. It's blocked. Angled off the glass. Held in by Gardner. And Gardner keeping it deep in the Boston zone. Under 9 minutes now remaining here in the third period.
Good shift there by Gardner. He was challenged by Horton coming out of the zone, but he saw the puck when Horton didn't. Kept it inside the zone single-handedly.
Barkowski rolls it across now. Here is Dougie Hamilton with it. Bruins have been down to five defensemen in this game seven.
See, this is an area where Boston has struggled. I mean, coming out of their zone, their first half, they just look perplexed with Toronto jamming the neutral zone.
Now McQuaid able to hold it in. Hoists it back in deep. Gunnarsson gets a stick on it, but Marchand gets it back now for the Bruins. Now Jágr takes it. Boychuk moves up from the point, but the Leafs able to clear it. McQuaid. Center ice, sends it along the boards behind Reimer. Far side, picked up by Jágr. Plays it off the board. Alpina wraps it onto the far side. Chara holding it in. Backhands it toward the Toronto net. Lyles for the Leafs. Up the far side, it'll be held in by Chara. Back to the net with a wrist shot, and Reimer covers up here as Marchand doing his best to stir things up with John Michael Lyles. .746 remaining in the third period of this game. Seven, Nathan Horton has brought the Bruins to within two. Welcome back to Boston. I want to remind you, over on the NBC Sports Network, Rangers and Capitals. Currently in that game seven. Then tomorrow we'll have game one of the Eastern Conference semifinal between Ottawa and Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh at 7:30 Eastern. Followed on the NBC Sports Network by game one between San Jose and the defending Stanley Cup champion Los Angeles Kings. Romowski gets this puck in deep. 7.5 remaining here in the third period. Leafs with a 4-2 lead. Bill Kessel with a goal and an assist here in the third. As Lucic will send this puck along the boards behind Reimer. Picked up by Hamilton, a shot save made by Reimer. Punched it right out between the circles. And overskating it is Fratton. Hamilton tries to make him pay, but it's picked off. And Colburn now, lead pass just missed connecting there with Fratton. He'll pick it up though, and hit shot missed on the angle against Rask. Joffrey Lupo gets to it. Now Fratton chips it back to the corner. Joffrey Lupo chopped off his stick, now run into by Lucic. And it's David Krejci who starts it back the other way. Hands it off for Peverly. One of the Leafs falls down. Peverly now sends it out to the line. Barkowski with it. Flips it along the end board. Tyler Seguin. Now Chris Kelly. Seguin again gets a stick on it. Bratton tries to clear, held in, Barkowski waits. Now lets it go, tipped in front, picked up by Seguin, put it right in front! It just missed! Getting a stick on it there was Zdeno Chara. He had a wide open net. If he gets a stick on that puck.
Smart play by Barkowski. He waited to get traffic in front. He knew nobody was there at first.
Everly back the other way, turns, hands it off, McQuaid sends it to the corner. Lionel Byrne up the board, Kadri got a stick on it, didn't get it out. Now Kelly for Sagan. Take it back by Kadri, he hands it off for Lupo, who will angle it off the boards. And back into the Boston end, Rask comes out, puts it up the middle looking for Brad Marchand. Kadri steps into him, and then it is slapped by Kessel back deep into the Boston zone. 5.5 remaining here in the third period. Toronto with a 4-2 lead over Boston. Trying to come back from a 3-1 series deficit. Marchand at the faceoff dot finds Boychuk straight away. Puck ends up in the corner. Skated off now by Grabowski. And he'll just lay it back to center ice. Hamilton slides it across. Putup comes up with it. Gunnarsson just clears it out. Icing here on the touch-up by Chara.
Boston Bruins swarming everywhere, getting pucks to the net. Bartkowski had done a good job up the point. He waited till he got a little traffic in front. There's the initial deflection. Chara comes in late on the play, gets one swipe at it. Toronto doing a nice job of sorting things out. Lupo comes back, gets on the hands of Chara. It might have been a little late had that puck come out just a little bit closer to the big guy. He might have been able to sweep it into the open side, but the battling in that final 10 feet in front of the crease, in front of James Reimer, is where it's all about now.
Brian, the Rangers have taken a 3-0 lead in Washington in the second period of that game seven. Well, if these scores hold up, Toronto would open up at home against the Rangers. They would have home ice advantage as the number 5 seed. The Rangers, remember, the number 6 seed. Now a bouncing puck deflects back in toward Reimer. Recovers up. Down to 4:34 remaining in the third period. Nathan Horton has a goal here in the third, but his team still trails game 7 by 2. Overall pick back in 2006 for the Bruins was Phil Kessel, and boy, he has faced a lot of media scrutiny, Brian, in his 4 years as a Maple Leaf, especially when he plays the Bruins.
Exercising some demons in this game, though. That was the easiest goal he scored all year, hanging in the edge of the paint, and that was a really smart play. On the 2-on-1, he made the right shot. It didn't go in on the first shot, but going for that far pad always allows your teammate a chance at a rebound. It was the perfect rebound right out to Kadri, and a clinching goal, perhaps, in this game. 1-1 for Phil Kessel.
Tied for 7th in scoring in the shortened NHL season, along with Chris Kunitz with 52 points in 48 games. Remember, he was acquired by Toronto for 2 first-round picks that turned out to be Tyler Seguin and Dougie Hamilton. And then, of course, when the Bruins won the Cup in Seguin's rookie year, it just added more fuel to the fire for the critics of the trade on the Toronto side. Now Krejci sends it across, knocked away by MacArthur. Driven hard to the board by Lucic. No call coming. He was a ways away from the board when he took that hit, but he bounces right back up as Phaneuf angles it out to center ice.
That was a tough hit. Gunnarsson bounced right back up, going for a loose puck. Both Lucic and Gunnarsson. Lucic playing hard. Gunnarsson really good in his own zone. He does hit him from the backside. Gunnarsson is aware that Lucic is coming, and Lucic is so big and strong on his feet, and you have so much more leverage when you're coming from that angle. Gunnarsson, fortunately, right back up. No penalty on the play. Lucic has been one of the most effective players for the Boston Bruins, certainly in this third period. Gunnarsson seen a lot of him. He and Dion Phaneuf pair together a lot against whoever's the hottest line on any given night.
Now Chara. He's taken down in the slot area, picked up, and a breakaway from center ice. Fratton one-on-one against Rask to the backhand, and it slid off his stick and wide. C. Second game, seven for Tuukka Rask, both in this building. The other one, the loss to the Flyers back in 2010. Remember, Rask was a former first-round pick of the Toronto Maple Leafs back in 2005. He was the 21st pick overall and was picked up by Boston in exchange for Raycroft. Bouncing puck here is recovered in front of the Toronto net. Benson ahead for Lupul, who drops it back into the Boston zone. Off the stick of Peverly and driven by McClement back into the Boston end. Most of this Boston crowd hanging in here with 2:40 remaining in the third period. Their team down by two. Reimer pokes it to the boards. Sagan. Now the puck comes across in front of the Toronto net. And Brian, last night we saw a game seven between Detroit and Anaheim that the Red Wings were able to win on the road. And a great player on that losing end, Corey Perry, without a goal in a seven-game series. And you see what Tyler Seguin's gone through here without a point.
Sometimes for all the opportunities you get, I mean, you just can't find the back. You can't find the magic. Seguin's had great success in past playoffs, and certainly the year that the Bruins won the Cup. But you're going to go through stretches like that. Unfortunately, sometimes it is in a playoff series, and it lasts the whole round.
Now Gardner angles it off the boards.
I've seen guys bounce back the next series and be the most dominant player, but do you get that second chance?
Extra attacker on for the Bruins. Tuukka Rask off the bench. Six skaters out here, two goal difference, minute and a half remaining in game number seven. Out to Zdeno Chara with a shot. Changes direction to the right pad, save by Reimer. Out to the point now. Bergeron across for Chara. He hammers one here. Save, rebound, and score! Bruins score! Like they did last night, late in game six, to get to within one, and this sets up a very interesting minute and 22 seconds.
Milan Lucic again, the most dominant guy, just gets in good body position and refuses to give it up. He'll get the puck back to the point, and the shot hits the target. Lucic gets free, gets his hands free for a second. Reimer can't handle the rebound. And Toronto backing out of the way so that Reimer could see it. You could see Gunnarsson. Look at Gunnarsson moves out of the way. When he does that, he creates space and time for Lucic, and Gunnarsson can't recover to Lucic. That's the dilemma that all defensemen have in front of the net. Whether you're covering Milan Lucic or anybody else for the Toronto Maple Leafs, if you stand in front and battle Lucic, you're helping screen your goaltender. We've seen that happen already in this game, where Zdeno Chara screened his goaltender and there was no chance on one of the goals against Boston. Other times you back away like Gunnarsson did, your goaltender sees it, but then you can't recover as the defenseman to make the play.
Timeout by Claude Julien and the Boston Bruins is presented by Gatorade Frost. Light, crisp, taste. Lucic scored the only goal for the Bruins last night after the goaltender had been pulled in a 2-0 game. It was Mikhail Grabowski who iced it, trying to hit an empty net that set up a faceoff. And again, we talked about faceoff. But right now, the Kadri goal set up by Kessel is the difference of the game. But still a minute 22 remaining. Do Chara and the Bruins have enough in the tank to get this thing to overtime?
Toronto's going to have to get in the shooting lanes a little bit better, too. They've given too much time and space to the Boston defensemen.
Bruins control the draw. Rask, as you can see, is still in his net. As the puck comes up the ice, he makes his way toward the bench. Krejci gets a deep extra attacker. It's on to Jeremy Jagr. Now Chara jams it around the board. Here comes Jagr. Then along the end boards. Panuk, good clear. Now it ends up along the boards again. Out to the line, Jagr sets it up here. Bergeron far side. Krejci back to Bergeron. Bergeron with a high side and score! Bruins have scored to tie the game! Can you believe this?
There are people in the parking lot scrambling to get back into the building here in Boston. Bergeron with the shot from the point, and the big man is the screen. Look at 33, Zdeno Chara. He is going to camp in front of the net, and then Bergeron is going to pick his spots. How can I get it through? There is the shot. The crossing patterns in front of Reimer don't allow him to see it properly. Toronto does not do a good job out against Bergeron up high. And that is patience and skill from Bergeron, threading that one through with the big screen in front. Incredible.
Second goal of the series with just over 50 seconds remaining.
Toronto just wasn't putting enough pressure on the defensemen of Boston. And because of that, Bergeron was able to hold on and pick his spot. Reimer never saw that. It's a total eclipse when you have Chara in front of you. Now they got a delay here. Fans keep throwing the towels on the ice. That's what they were waiting for here. Every time they pick up one or two, the fans throw three or four more back on.
Well, they need to make an announcement here. This really isn't necessary. These fans have been so good here in Boston.
An involuntary timeout.
Yeah, exactly.
Going object through the ice is strictly prohibited. Violators are subject to arrest.
Zdeno Chara up front, a terrific tactic, because you just can't move the guy who's 265 plus with equipment on. The will of this Boston team, though, really showing through. Look at Chara in front, gains his position. Now look, watch Toronto, a little bit too much there. Kuhlman comes out and doesn't do a very good job. Kuhlman is 41 against Bergeron. Bergeron changes the angle and waits just another heartbeat while Kuhlman goes by him. Kuhlman should have been much more patient, stay in the shooting lane and take that shot away. Make it much more tough for Bergeron to get it through. Bergeron did, Chara screens, tie ball game.
Nathan Horton at 9:18 started the comeback, and then goals 31 seconds apart.
Milan Lucic really did a heck of a job in this game, really, but certainly in the third period. Lucic has been their guy. I mean, he's gone to the front of the net. He's been really active on the bench, very vocal. Big goal, huge goal. We'll see where it stands up in the scheme of things.
Still 50.2 seconds remaining in regulation time. Kelly, Peverly, Marchand for the Bruins, McClement, Lupo, and Kuhlman for the Maple Leafs. Gunnarsson plays it ahead. It's deflected into the Boston zone. Wojcik plays it around. Now Wojcik up the boards, and it bounces all the way back. Going to be far enough for icing. On the touch-up by Fanuk. And the face-off dominance of the Bruins will be tested again here on a face-off deep in the Boston end.
What an extraordinary ebb and flow to this game. The total dominance physically early on by the Boston Bruins. The recovery by Toronto slowly taking the game away, being very opportunistic and playing very sound hockey. And then pure desperation that Claude Julien talked about from his team. He wanted to see it from the beginning. He got it at the end.
Puck ends up in the corner. Heavily gets to it now for Chara. Chara starts it back, 20 seconds remaining in regulation. Marchand across the line. Reimer save, rebound, chance! Poked away by Reimer! Oh, he gave up a rebound! And the Bruins were unable to get it back on goal.
Peverly had bounced over his stick when he was trying to control it. He wanted one more second to shoot it, and it bounced on him. Peverly can't believe it. He is just looking up towards the heavens saying, really? I could have done it. I could have done it. Marchand with terrific speed just gets it on net. Here comes the big rebound off the toe. See how it's rolling? See how it bounced on him? He controlled it for a second. You'll get a real good look at it here. Bounce, bounce, and roll. As soon as he pushed his stick forward, the stick literally went right up underneath the puck. Beverly was robbed.
The only thing better than a Game 7 in the Stanley Cup playoffs is a Game 7 overtime, and that's what we have. And with the Subway overtime intermission, Russ and Anson will talk about this amazing, amazing Bruins comeback and a live look in at the other Game 7 going on between the Rangers and the Capitals. Well, the Bruins are probably thankful this isn't like the regular season and you start overtime right away. They're going to get a break. We'll step away as well, but stay with us for the Subway Overtime Intermission Report coming up after this. Holiday Inn Express. Dave Strader, Brian Engblom. We've set a new first-round record with our 17th overtime game. But, Brian, it didn't look early in the third period like this game had any chance of going overtime.
No, it didn't. The Boston Bruins, with 7 or 8 minutes to go, kept pushing, but they had that look about them that, how are we going to do this? Toronto seemed to have it all in the bag. And then Horton scored, and then Lucic went to work. The Krejci line coming through. And then in the clutch, big Zdeno Chara with the screen. And Bergeron, who's had trouble finding the back of the net, he and his line struggling. They do it at the most critical juncture in the game.
Sixth consecutive year that the Boston Bruins have played a Game 7 in the playoffs. And the third year in a row, they will play a Game 7 on home ice that will go to overtime. Well, Julian trying to shout instructions. And, oh, now a water bottle comes out on the ice. I think that was intentional.
Yeah,
Julian wants to get his point across.
Yeah, he wants them to go forward with the puck. I know that's what he was yelling at Krejci. The music is so loud in here, it doesn't matter how loud he screams. He had to motion forward. Didn't matter because Krejci didn't even make an attempt at that. He wasn't ready for the faceoff.
So the Leafs get it into the Bruins zone to start this overtime on a shot of steered aside by Tuukka Rask. MacArthur, high slot, Grabowski down low. And it swept in wide. And I mentioned 17th overtime game of these playoffs, and most of them have gone surprisingly quickly. And we saw the other night in Detroit in that Game 6 overtime goal by Zetterberg. Back the other way now. It is sent into the Boston zone. Boychuk. Rybarkowski. Angles it off the board. Ooh, Reimer just kept that right pad against the post.
Oh, no. You don't want to end an overtime game in Game 7 like that one. Anything can happen. This is just a shoot-in. Oh, it goes off the leg of one of the linesmen, which startled Reimer. Well, he did a good job. He got against the post. You have to be ready for anything. This young man in his first ever Game 7.
38-15, the faceoff numbers favor the Boston Bruins through regulation. But this one is won by McClement back to the corner. Van Riemsdyk wraps it around. Kessel chips it out to center ice. Picked up by Bergeron, sends it right back in. Jaromír Jágr gets there. Jágr. 11th on the all-time playoff goal-scoring list. He is one behind the great Jean Béliveau. As this puck is sent back into the Boston Bruins end, Chara off the board.
Toronto didn't get the puck to Kessel. Kessel actually had about two steps on Zdeno Chara, but they couldn't get the puck to him.
Marchand back the other way. Looks across, broken up by Gardner. Good stick there as the Bruins almost too many men on the ice.
It's going to be significant. You're a long ways away from your bench, just like the second period.
Here's Kessel with a shot up high. Boy, he can snap it from a long ways away. Kessel in deep now, hands it off for Kadri. Kadri, high slot, a chance here, Lupo, stopped by Rask. What a stop on Lupo by Tuukka Rask, but here's Lupo again. And down was Rask. He was able to keep it out of there. And the Bruins find the loose puck along the boards and clear it.
That's one of the line changes. Lupo came off the bench and Boston didn't see him.
Now Lupo looks ahead and just unable to get it, was flat, and he had some speed, but it leads to an icing call.
Tuukka Rask with absolutely a brilliant save on Joffrey Lupo. Lupo comes off the bench, he's right in the slot, he lets it go right away, and that toe save by Rask, very aware that the Toronto Maple Leaf player was alone in the high slot. Lupul came out from behind the net, an equally dangerous chance there from a different circumstance, and Glass made that save too.
Krejci and Colburn on this draw, and good hustle there by the Toronto wingers after the centerman had lost the draw. Now back the other way, the Bruins on the counterattack. Lucic bounces off that check, but then did lose his balance as Krejci sends it to the far side. Nathan Horton is there. He's been an overtime hero in a game seven. Krejci out to the line. Chara holds it in. Sends it deep. Horton is there. Lyles trying to keep him to the outside. Chara hammers one here. Head went just wide. Krejci intercepted by Colburn. He starts it back the other way. Chipped ahead by Pratt. Ooh, he was spun around there by Marchand. And the puck out of play.
Remember, the Boston Bruins are playing with only five defensemen. Seidenberg got hurt in the first period, only played 37 seconds. Zdeno Chara played over 32 minutes in regulation in this game. He played over 28 minutes last night, so he's played a full game, one full 60-minute game out of the two games in back-to-back nights.
Marchand for Jágr. Jágr hands it off. Pochuk shot, and that's Reimer covering it up as Phaneuf covers up on one of the Boston forwards. That's Patrice Bergeron underneath him.
Boston's had success at getting pucks back to the point and getting them through. That's how the winning goal was scored. Johnny Pochuk has a couple of goals in this series. They have goals from the defense tonight here too. Bartkowski scored the first goal of the game. Toronto's got a box out, have good coverage in their own zone, and they have to get in the shooting lane better.
Leafs have won a couple of draws here in overtime in their own zone. Now Phaneuf starts it back. Bergeron steps up on him in the neutral zone. Now McClement will hammer it in wide of the Boston goal. Pochuk, that bounces off a stick. Held in by Grabowski. Kuhlman trying to get himself free, hands it off. Gardner with a low shot. He just missed it wide. Here's Grabowski with it again. He's taken down. And back the other way comes Marchand. Taken right back by Kuhlman. Pochuk separates him from the puck.
Good stand up there by Pochuk. Kuhlman didn't expect that. Expected him to back off.
Now Gardner chips it ahead. Fratton across the line. Takes it wide with speed. Misses on the short side. Kelly moves it along. Tyler Seguin. And that's blocked by Gardner and up onto the netting out of play.
Oh, good stick there by Gardner. Right as Seguin was making the release of the shot, he got his stick in on it, deflected it up and over the glass. The quick up by Boston, trying to catch Toronto on a line change. They did, but look at Gardner, very patient. He sees that the shot is coming and just patiently just goes stick on stick and deflects that one right up into the netting.
Seguin without a shot in this game seven, is a minus two, still doesn't have a point in the series. But he loved to make up for all of that here in the overtime. Face-off win Bruins. Shot here, goes off of Seguin and bounces up onto the netting.
Yeah, speaking of Seguin, he just went off the face-off to the front of the net. A crossing pattern, a moving screen, whatever you want to call it. And Dougie Hamilton, the shooter from the point, waited exactly the right amount of time. Look at Seguin come from the right boards. Seguin gets position. Incredible eye-hand coordination these guys have. Gunnarsson, number 36 for Toronto, was actually doing a really good job. He made sure he was between Seguin and the net. Seguin still got a piece of it.
Nathan Horton on the bench has only one skate. He had to have the other one worked on. He's just getting it put back on, handed to him by the equipment manager. And Jaromir Jágr went down the tunnel momentarily. And Seguin with a shot, save made by Reimer. And he holds it there.
This is the most offensive confidence, really, in many ways we've seen from the Bruins. They are a different team now. For long stretches in the middle portion of this game, they didn't have much offensive confidence, and give Toronto credit for that. They're stealing pucks, they're turning it over, they're getting to the net, they're on top of the play again. Since the early stages of this game, the Boston Bruins regaining themselves after an incredible finish in regulation. There's Horton with two solid feet underneath him again.
Yeah, found his glove. Now he needs a stick. Now he's ready to go. Campbell comes off. Krejci, Lucic, Horton. They've led the comeback. They've led the way offensively throughout the series. Lucic wins the draw cleanly. To the net, no, it's blocked in a race for the puck, Fratton. And here comes Tuukka Rask way out of the net. And angles it off the inboard.
And Lupo is the one who blocked that shot. He was shaken up a little bit. He went right to the bench. But that's the way Toronto has to do it. Get in the shooting lanes like Lupo just did.
And Lupo kind of limping down the tunnel. Looks like he's just going to walk it off a little bit. Franson flips it ahead in wide of the Boston goal. Boychuk plays it on the far side. Now sent back for Boychuk. 5 minutes gone by here in this overtime period. Lucic waits. Now hands it off. Horton with a chance. And that was deflected wide on the glove side.
Gardner stick again.
Horton walks out near the line. Chara. For Krejci, down low for Lucic. Gardner lost his stick. Boy, he quickly goes back to get it. Now to the net, and Gardner got back to block it. Well, he's got a lot of poise to do that in that situation.
Some guys just have no nerves, it seems. They just keep playing no matter what.
Dougie Hamilton with it now. Thought about a stretch pass. Now he waits and finds Bergeron into the zone. Bergeron takes it wide behind the net. Looks to the front. Still hands on. Now he hands it off. Sagan sends it right off the goaltender Reimer. Back to the front again. It never got all the way through. Now Marchand with it. Hands it off. Bergeron on top. Rebound chance in front. Sagan is there. Puck comes free. Score! Patrice Bergeron, who tied the game and won it in overtime.
Incredible. Incredible pressure by the Bergeron line that had so much trouble scoring all during this series, but not on that last shift.
And you know what? Because Jaromir Jagr had gone down the tunnel, we were told it was Tyler Seguin back on that line.
Yes.
With Bergeron and Marchand, and they deliver. What a comeback by Boston.
Tyler Seguin was everywhere in this overtime. He had some good scoring chances. And he was in the midst of all of this play as well, too. They keep the puck inside the zone. Marchand does a good job battling against Franson. They get it back. That's the initial shot by Bergeron. And then battle in front of the net. Bergeron gets free and comes in.
Several times on that shift, Bergeron showed tremendous patience. When other players would have gotten rid of the puck, he held on to it. And then he comes back, and look at the jubilation on the faces of the Boston Bruins, and now the traditional handshake. Dion Phaneuf and Zdeno Chara. And now Phaneuf and Lucic. These teams have battled so hard, and this series has had so many ebbs and flows. Phil Kessel looked like he was going to completely shake the demons. Although, listening to his comments prior to Game 7, he already has. He's put it in the path. But he was such a big part of Toronto taking the lead with a goal and an assist. And then it all falls apart for Kessel and the Maple Leafs, and the Bruins are moving on. And now they await the outcome of the Rangers-Capitals Game 7, which has gone to 4-0 in favor of the Rangers. And if it stays that way, an original 6 matchup in the conference semifinals, with Boston having home ice advantage over the Rangers, and with all the sports history between the cities of New York and Boston, let alone the Rangers and Bruins, what a terrific series that will be, again, if it holds up for the Rangers, leading 4-0 early in the third. James Reimer, who was a big part of getting Toronto here, getting respect from Johnny Boychuk and the rest of the Boston Bruins. It's going to be very tough for this Toronto team to digest the way they lost this Game 7. But when you think of the strides that this organization has made this year in getting to the playoffs for the first time since 04 and extending a heavily favored Boston team to a Game 7, And it required the magic work of that man, Patrice Bergeron. Scoring with just over 50 seconds remaining in regulation. And then it's 6:05 of the overtime period. Not sure how many fans did leave the building. The place was about three quarters full, but everybody got back in, and now the hero is standing by down at ice level with Brian Engvall.
Patrice, when you dream about game sevens, do you think about endings like this?
Well, obviously, we'd like to make it a little bit easier on us, but, you know, we found a way. It's all that matters, and now we move on to the second round.
Talk about the emotion, what you guys were feeling and thinking at the end of regulation, trying to come up with two goals to tie it.
Well, we knew we had the offense to do it, which we had to believe, and we had to put the puck on net and find the rebounds. We did that on that third goal, and we had a great stream from Z on that fourth one, so it gave us some energy for overtime.
Going into the locker room, coming out and getting ready for this overtime period, how much confidence was there in the locker room going the way the game has gone tonight so far?
Well, I think a lot. I mean, obviously, we got the momentum going right away and that at the end of that third period, so they gave us the legs and the energy we needed to finish the job in overtime.
You look like you didn't have a worry in the world.
Well, I think, like I said, we have a great group of guys, and we've been there before, so we just relied on our experience to do the job.
Congratulations. Thank you, Patrice.
Thank you.
Dave.
Just a few years ago, these Boston fans saw their team blow a 3-0 series lead and a 3-0 lead in a Game 7 on home ice to lose a Game 7. Now they see their team make a miraculous comeback from 3-down in the third period to tie it late in regulation and then get this goal from Patrice Bergeron to win it, to advance in the second round. For Brian Engvall and the rest of our crew, I'm Dave Strader. Thanks for joining us. Now let's send it to Russ Thaler.